Hey there everybody, it's Nathan Kuhl with NathanKuhlPhoto.com, and in this tutorial I want to cover the detent plungers on 360 pano heads and specifically how that relates to making then 360 virtual tours for real estate. Now, as you may recall from prior videos, we use one of these pano heads. You might already be familiar with this or have one already, and these are used then to put on your DSLR and to rotate around and get then a real high quality 360 pano, something that's a step above using the portable 360 cameras. If you're not familiar with this, it's a very simple thing to use and also to purchase. There's a couple different options, which I'm going to show in this video as well, but I also have links to those other videos in the description for this video, as well as links to the various gear. Now, in particular, what I'm going to be covering is these, like you notice on this, the Nodal Ninja 6, there's these little blue knobs on here. A lot of questions come in, what are those? What are they used for? So I'm going to cover that, but I'm going to start out by showing a very less expensive alternative. As you know, if you've ever priced a Nodal Ninja head, they are expensive. So I do have some alternatives for less expensive ones. Also, near the end of this video, I'm going to be covering an even less expensive alternative, something that I'm building up right now. So I'm doing some prototyping with some parts, and I'm going to be showing you that. So it can get into very tight spaces, costs almost nothing, and it also takes less shooting time. So something I'm developing, and I will have a future video for, but I want to give you a sneak peek at that. Once again, after I cover some of this, will be at the end of the video. So anyways, let's get in really close and take a look at these detent plungers, as they're known, and also the lock knobs, how they're used and how you can use them specifically for real estate photography. So to recap just real quickly, if you've never seen this done before, having a DSLR mounted on this pano head like this allows us to rotate around. We're doing four different shots usually, and then one straight up. But the biggest thing is rotating using this rotator down here, where we would do 0, 90, 180, 270 degrees. That gives us our four shots that went, and then we can stitch together to make our virtual tour panos, our 360 panos. So that's the principle of it, and that's how it works. Now, I've moved this out of the way. This particular arm, usually this would be right over top almost of that nadir right there, over top of it, and that way we don't get what's known as the parallax error. And to calibrate that, once again, I've got a few videos back, and I've got a link to that in the description for the video. For this tutorial, though, I'm just going to move that out of the way so that we can actually see these detent plungers. Let me get in really close and show you what I mean. So getting in here real close, we can see that, for instance, we're at the 180 degree mark there. And as we'd rotate this, we'd hear a click. And we'll go to the next and you hear that little click sound in there. Boom, go to 180. And that tells us that we're at the position that we want. Now, depending on the quality of the pano head, that will lock a little bit better. So in this particular case, this is just the less expensive Neewer head. It's about $120. Once again, link in the description for the video, where a Nodal Ninja 6 might cost you about $450, $420, something around that range. So this works fairly well. It's not going to be necessarily the highest quality for everything you'd want to do. There's some nicer things about the Nodal Ninja 6, but the one thing here is it's very simple with its detent plungers, these knobs right here. Now, actually, this one here is the detent plunger. And then there's always another knob over here, and I'll show it on the Nodal Ninja 6 here next, is that this is the lock knob. And what this does is if you were to screw that in really tight in its lock position, which it shows there, then it would lock that pano head in place. So it's going to be real hard to move that. So that's great if you're moving it around and you want to lock it. So we just unscrew that a little bit. And by the way, there's always a cable on these pano heads so that you don't lose any of these knobs. Now the next thing is then the detent plunger. And you just, in the bottom of that, let me unscrew this, there's a little ball bearing. And that ball bearing then starts clicking on these various little detents that are inside the pano head. And they're labeled here with like 90, 60, 45, 30, 15. And depending on the complexity of the head, there'll be various ones. Those are the degrees of stop. So if you want to stop every 30 degrees, you'd put your plunger in there. If you want to stop every 45 degrees, for real estate photography, for the most part, using the fisheye lens like I talk about in the other videos and in the book, then we'd be using the 90 degree mark. So we just screw that guy right back into there. And once we have that screwed in there, then we'll start clicking at the positions for the, boom, 180 degree mark. We go over to the next one, which will be 90 degrees this direction. and we hear another click. So that gives us that rotation. My rotator head's coming just a little bit loose there, so I can just loosen that up a little bit. But anyways, that's what that detent's for, is to have that go, and as you go around, you can hear that little click that's going around. And each time it does that, that's falling into one of the places of our rotation of every 90 degree increment, like that at the 180. Now let's take a closer look though at the more complex setup on the Nodal Ninja 6. So this is the more complex Nodal Ninja 6, definitely a higher quality pano head, obviously a little bit more expensive. So it has three different knobs on it. I'm going to show you those. You can hear though immediately right off the bat, it's a more of a sturdier click. When we're starting to move that around, it actually sounds more metallic. It's very sturdy. This is a very sturdy pano head. So once again though, the detents are basically the same. You can see our little datum point is showing that it's at the 90 degree mark. Now, what makes this unique, having the three knobs, one of them is lock. So we go to this middle one, and it actually has then a little, you know, thing here that says lock, and it's this real big one here. So when you have this guy in place, he doesn't have the plunger, just like the other one on the Neewer head, he will lock that pano head in place. So you screw that in, loosen it up a little bit, and once you loosen it up, then you can move it around. Now, it makes it complex here on the Nodal Ninja, and most things in life that are very complex, as you want to have more features to them, you got stuff in there that you probably might not need. We'll get back here to where we've got a good click here. It's 180. So what I've done here, there's two plungers. I only need to use the 90 degree mark for most of the real estate photography. Depending on what you're doing though, once again, different type of lenses, you can do something else. For instance, we're using the fisheye lens typically for making virtual tours for real estate photography. So we just need the four shots around, possibly one shot up and down, as I talk about in the other videos and book. But what we'll do is we just use the 90 degree mark here. So we've got this detent plunger. Once again, it has the same little ball bearing at the very tip of it. It goes in there. That's the 90 degree hole. We can see that there's other ones. There's 60, there's 36. Look how fluid that is too as it moves. Just a really good quality head. So anyways, we'll just put that back in there to the 90 degree mark. And then when we do, every time we move that plunger, that head, we can hear the plunger hit those detents that are in the head. Boom, boom, really clicks in place very nicely. Now, the other one is for another type of increment. So if you wanted to have it go every few increments, like let's say that you wanted it to go, yeah, you've got 90, but maybe you want to have it every 10 degrees also, or every 15 degrees, this is the 10 degree part. You put this guy into there, excuse me, I know my hands are in the way here, but we'll just screw him in there. And when we do, you'll hear a whole bunch of clickety clickety click. Now I used to use it this way because sometimes I would not be using the fisheye lens depending on the pano that I would be using. So I just knew it was every 10 degree increment. It's a very convenient thing to do if you're doing other types of panos, other types of lenses. But all you have to do is if you just want the 90 degree mark now, you would just loosen that particular one and then you'd be back to your 90 degree clicks. Just like we had it before. So that's the big difference there. Once again, it is a much higher quality pano head. Having the three thumb wheels on here does make it confusing, but to recap, the real big one is lock, then just use the 90 degree. The other one over here, just keep that loose, and it also has the cable on the bottom. Now, next I wanna show something that's a little bit different, something once again I'm prototyping to start using for real tight spaces, something that's less expensive and also would take less time to shoot. Let's take a look at that next. All right, so to wrap things up on the third option here, this is something, once again, it's still in the prototype phase, but this is for getting into very tight areas. So thinking outside the box when you're doing 360 virtual tours, it's not necessarily houses. There are other things that need to have 360s done, like RVs and whatnot. So this is one option. Now, the idea here is that I've built up this little thing. I'm going to get in closer and show it, but you can then rotate this around and know where you are at any particular area. Now, if you use, obviously, this doesn't tilt up, so it's a very simple setup here, which all that it is, it's an L bracket on a camera. And if I just loosen that up here, you can see it down in its simplest form here that this is all that it really is. It's just a very simple nodal rail and then some other pieces that are down here. And I'll cover some of that in a future video. But the idea here is still the same on what you would do even for the simplest type of pano head. Now, just to cover some of what will be coming up in later videos is that the idea here is that if you shoot wide enough enough with a fisheye lens, then you might not need your zenith shot. So here with, for instance, on a full frame camera, instead of using a 12 millimeter fisheye, you can use an 8. And if you use an 8, you can turn it into typically a full frame fisheye by taking off this tulip lens hood. So that's something that the Samyang provides. So if you were to use this on a crop sensor camera, you would leave that on. But if you're using full frame, you could take this off. And now you've got a lot wider shot. You might not need the zenith on using your camera full frame. So anyways, I'll just put that back on to protect the lens. And then let's get in a little bit closer here and take a look at some of the setup and how this also relates to that type of rotation. So what this basically is I'm using a travel tripod because I need to get into some real tight spaces here. And on top of it is just mounted a very simple little pano head, Arca Swiss mount, and then what's called a nodal rail. And once again, these are just in prototype phases right now. Once I get this all squared away, I'll be sharing this with you on how to set this up for yourself. These typically don't have any detents, but they do have, if I loosen this up a little bit, they do have a little dot that will line up. So I can go here to my zero portion of the shot, so I know that I'm at that angle and that looks good. So I'd, you know, shoot from there, I'd loosen that up and then move that to my 90. As I'm moving this around, you notice there's another dot, so I don't have to follow my head around, my pano head around to see if it went to 90. Even though it doesn't have a detent, these dots are every 90 degrees, so I can just go and say, okay, that's good there, that'd be my next one, and then the next one here. Now of course it's covering up because of shadow, but that'd be my next position to shoot from, and then the next dot that lines up, that would be my zero there. So by shooting wide enough, once again, taking those four shots on this very simple rotator here, then you get yourself enough to stitch together a fairly good pano for those really tight spaces. It does cost a lot less than obviously the other alternatives. It's a lot more work though. And if you're doing inside most of the real estate photography, this might not be the best option for it, but for tight spaces, it will be. Once again, video on that will be coming up shortly. Now, a lot of the things about using these pano heads and also the editing that's covered in prior videos and also in my latest book, which is Virtual Tour Photography for Real Estate. I also have a link to that down in the description for this video. But I've got a lot of these free tutorials online, more are coming up. If you did like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. It won't cost anything. And as soon as one of these videos is posted, you'll be the first to know. Thanks a lot for watching. Until next time, take care, be safe, and get out there and shoot something.